Let's play! Whoa!
Hey there, ladies and gentlemen! You all may call me Pharaoh, and welcome back to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts 3. Last time we left off, we continued fighting against the members of the real Organization 13, which included Zigbar and the Riku from the past, I guess. Terrazenort, Vanitas, Sayax, or Aiza, and Shion. Which isn't, she's not good, and she's back, and so is Roxas, and so is Terra. So many reunions happened, it's so great. And now we are, it almost looks like we're in a point of no return. I'm a little afraid to continue, but this needs to happen. I don't know if this is going to be the finale or not. I'll play by ear. Either way, let's climb up this thing, and I say we're gonna be in for a lot of cutscenes, so here we go.
Riku! Your Majesty!
Huh?
Sora!
About time.
Sorry. Zemnis! Where's Kairi?
Wait, huh? Is she in trouble?
Yeah, Zemnis took her.
Settle down, boy.
It's Sora!
The 13 darknesses and 7 lights have clashed 9 times, yielding these 9 keys.
Keys?
We are 4 short, but those 4 keys will be produced here and now.
Yeah, sure. And what makes you think there'd ever be any way we'd help you with that?
You forget I plan for every eventuality.
Kairi!
If you do summon Kingdom Hearts, we will defeat you. And we will close it again.
Perhaps. That is, if you survive that long.
Oh boy, I don't even know which one I want to start with. I'm just gonna do this. So I guess it's against Yunzenort, Ansem, and Zemnis. Oh, okay, well, takes care of that a little bit. I'm worried about him, about Zaynor himself, how that's gonna be, but we'll worry about that later. Oh great, I'm alone, that's great. Is this just a, whoa, okay. Oh, really? I gotta do this on my own? Well, alright, I'll try my best. Hopefully it's like a temporary thing where Riku and Kingmaker will just come back eventually, but I don't know if this is like something I gotta survive, or I'm just not sure who I want to focus on defeating. If anybody's in my line of sight, that's who I'm gonna go for. So, I mean, I'm dealing lots of good damage, that's all I care about. Especially when I get into my ultimate form, that's really gonna help out. Boom. See, like, but here's what, it's that thing again where, like, oh, Mickey and Riku are back. But it's like a fight like this, I think it would have been so awesome if it was all 3 of them separately, but it's understandable at the same time. You don't want to have 13 final bosses. I think one of them is gone? I don't know who, but. Or no, he's right there again. Okay, I should have been watching out for that. Might as well do my finisher now. Oh, this is so great. Oh, somebody's dead. I don't know who that was.
What's so funny?
I told you. There's a high price to pay for all of this.
And what price would that be?
I'll go back to my time and live out my life. But Sora, you're done now. Your journey ends here.
What?
Goodbye, Sora. Your time in this world is...
Go on.
That was overly dramatic. It's like, you can't finish like, the one last thing you said? Come on. Anyway, I guess that takes care of young Xehanort. So, I don't know. It's like, what do you mean my time in this world? God. The whole time travel thing they kind of introduced here kind of goes through my head a little bit. Because for the longest time, there was no such thing as time travel, at least to my knowledge in the game. Oh, crap. That's going to hurt. Yep. Oh, well. But then all of a sudden it's like, yeah, he traveled back in time to get all these vessels. I'm like, okay. I don't know. I just kind of go with it at this point. I've always said that the writing could be a lot better in the Kingdom Hearts series, but, you know, because I'm just a fan, I guess I kind of just give her a free pass a little bit, even though I probably shouldn't. But, I just enjoy the series, you know? It looks like Xemnas might be the closest one to be finished. Or no, now it's Anton. It could be either one. So it's like a little bit of roulette. Place your bets right now. Who am I going to kill first? I'm just mashing X. And then whoever gets in my way is... That's it. Okay. Might as well heal. Gotta say, I love the music, and it's also making me think that the Kingdom Hearts Orchestra is going to be coming to my town in about a month or two, and I'm very tempted in going, but I'm already going to the Final Fantasy concert symphony in September, so...
Bested yet again.
I know that you have a heart. What do you feel? Was it worth it?
I feel the emptiness where my companions once stood. I took them for granted. And now I have nothing. My first surge of emotion in years. For as long as I can remember, and it's loneliness. Do you see? A heart is just pain.
Pain is being human, Xemnas.
Really? It must take incredible strength.
Did this game actually make me feel a little bit bad for Xemnas? That seems odd, but okay. You know, I do find it a little bit fitting. Oh no, this is gonna suck. Yeah. I find it a little fitting that we're actually finishing up this group with Ansem, the big baddie in the first game in the series, and he's going to be one of the final ones in this game. Does Gladney help? It does. I should have done that ages ago. This brings back so many memories, and like, this is making me sad. I'm about to finish it right here, right now. Now what's going to happen?
Ansem.
What a journey you and I have had.
You know, it's strange. I think I'm gonna miss you.
Your strength is vaster than darkness. I knew I never stood a chance. Part of me wanted to defy my fate. But when the others betrayed us, I found I did not care. And then, nothing else seemed to matter anymore.
Ansem.
What? It is time to move on, boy. There is more to seek. So go forth now and seek it.
Keys we have now. Leaving just one more. Now, Sora. Darkness and light's final clash.
Kairi!
You require motivation. Keyblade War will finally reach its conclusion. Ah, the Keyblade is complete. Kingdom Hearts. I call upon your true form. Open now and show me the world to come.
We thought you might be able to use a couple of more half points.
Donald. What? Goofy.
Typical. You can't do anything without us, Sora.
Now wipe those tears. And let's go stop Master Xehanort.
Yeah. But he controls Kingdom Hearts now. And Kairi. You worried? Guys,
Sorry we took so long. Had a couple of plot points that needed ironing out.
Master Xehanort.
He did it. He opened Kingdom Hearts.
So what now?
We've still got one hope!
Your Majesty! Riku! Are you okay?
We're fine!
Yeah.
What hope?
It's Xehanort. During the Mark of Mastery exam, we learned that he can transcend space and time. He's a portal, and we can use that to trap him.
But it won't be easy. Aqua, Riku, I'll need both your help if we're gonna push Xehanort out of this world.
Understood.
Wait! I'll do it.
What?
Kingdom Hearts is a much bigger threat. Let me handle Xehanort while you guys keep it shut.
Right.
Okay, Sora.
I got this.
You can't forget about us.
Without keyblades, it's not like we'll be much help here.
Three half pints together again.
Let's move. The darkness is spreading.
Sora.
Huh? Oh, hey.
Kairi will be all right. I can feel it.
Thank you.
What in the absolute fudge is going on? I mean, oh, they said they're going to stop him in between space and time because he can traverse through that. But man, is it something else. And I thought, like, he straight up killed Kairi, which death is a weird concept in the series, because it's like, you think they're dead, but they're, like, actually coming back from one form or another. It's weird.
Whoa! Where are we?
It's beautiful.
Admire it another time.
Right. We need to find Master Xehanort.
Yeah!
Sora, let's go check out the town!
Well, this really is beautiful, though. This is like the, this was the beginning where, I mean, I don't think it's a secret, but a young Erequis and Xehanort were playing chess. Like, I think it's right up there.
Let's see.
I love how we can still take pictures. Well, since we're here.
Jeez.
Absolute wrong time to be taking pictures, but did they give a name to this? I thought they did, but it's skipping my mind. Oh, and the glossary is finished too. The Keyblade itself. What do they say about it? Implement created as a counterpart to Kingdom Hearts and the only key that can open it. Oh, okay, well, I guess it makes sense. It was destroyed during Great Battle in the past. It was reforged from seven hearts of pure light clash of 13 pure darknesses. And he said that it happened 9 times before. And he needed 4 more keys to form 13 keys to get the Keyblade. It all over the place. Oh yeah, by the way, I really did miss this key, this chest. It was in the beginning, right before we had to fight the first group of battles I did when I got to the Keyblade Graveyard. So I can go back and get it, I think, after I beat the game. I don't know if I can go back now, unfortunately, and do it. Unless this gives me an option. Hey! It does give me an option. Shoot, I'm gonna do it now. So what is the stairway to the sky? Interesting. I mean, is this still technically? It's not still the Keyblade Graveyard, is it? Or is this even a physical manifestation of whatever? Or is this like a weird entity? I don't even know anymore. No, I'm not gonna go back. Or wait a minute. Hold on. I want to try something. First, I'm going to go back. I think it was here. And I'm going to see if I can grab that one treasure chest. And I'm also going to see if I can talk to everybody. Because, I mean, you guys are probably going to hate me, but I kind of don't want to continue forward just yet. Because I have absolutely no idea if this is the point of no return. It probably is. But I want to kind of keep the entirety of the finale, like, self-contained. I'd rather have it, like, one big video, you know? So I'm not really sure if I'm going to keep it here or not. Yeah, see, this was the path I couldn't go to. And there's a damn treasure chest right here! A Mega Elixir. And that's all my freaking trophies. Or all the treasure chests. Complete the treasure section of the gummy phone. Huh. Man. Thank you. Okay, go back into the game now, please. That feels good. So that's how you get all the treasures in Kingdom Hearts 3. So. Okay, cool. Can I just... I'm sure I should have just, I probably should have just went ahead and teleported there, but this area is pretty short as it is, so I guess it doesn't matter if I just kind of glide my way through. You know, they call it the labyrinth, but they're so nice enough to give us the map to the area, so it's like, oh, you're not really lost. Don't worry about it. But I would like to see if I can talk to everybody up here. I would assume they're all just standing around. Man, oh man. I didn't realize how humongo Kingdom Hearts was. Damn. Okay. And I thought it was also known that there are different forms of Kingdom Hearts. Like, there are different Kingdom Hearts, like the ones of man and dreams and other things. Like, I thought that was the case. And where is everybody? I would have thought they'd all be standing right here. They all just said, oh, well, Sora, Donald, and Goofy are God knows where. Let's go home. Let's sleep. Let's hang out the Final Fantasy characters that didn't show up in this game. I'm not salty that they didn't show up. It's understandable why they didn't. I think they were there in the beginning of the series because they wanted to kind of bridge that aspect of Disney and Square Enix and Final Fantasy, and they also helped tell the story. But by the time you get to Kingdom Hearts 3, like, your story is the one being told. Like, they're not per se needed anymore. So it's understandable why they're not here. I would have liked to see them, though, personally. And I would have loved to have a Sephiroth boss fight.
Leonor has to be somewhere in town.
Doesn't seem that's the case. I'm not sure if I want to continue or not. Like, I was gonna keep going until they gave me like that point of no return message, because usually every game does. So that's kind of what I want to do, but maybe I can just explore the town a little bit.
It sure is awful quiet here.
There's no one around.
Hey! What? What's going on? Are you serious?
I don't think they're the locals.
Ready?
I mean, what the hell, game? You can't just do that and then not explain. Although, actually, they really can. They've been doing that throughout the entirety of the series. Actually, it reminds me... Whoa! Okay, no, we actually do gotta fight them. Oh, okay. Okay, shoot. Fighting. I'm fighting these guys. They look cool. I like their outfits going on here. Does it make sense? It seems like more adult in the Kingdom Hearts series. I don't know why it looks... I just like the style of them. It seemed to be going down. At least this focus on attacks on this one guy seems to be going down pretty easily, so that I'm happy about. There's one. Or is it only just one ahead to defeat? Oh. I guess it's a lot easier than I thought.
Of all the places to be sent.
Master Xehanort!
Behold, this town. Once a seat of power for all Keyblade wielders, it is the nexus from which all worlds spring. And my other selves can be one. United in Scala et Kylum.
Okay, just keep throwing things at me. Scala et Kylum? That's the town? Like, ooh boy, okay. Cool looking town, cool looking name. I wonder if there's any hidden meaning in that though. What's going on? Oh, I guess there really is no point in overtrying. I guess we're just doing this now. Okay guys, final boss fight time, I guess. He's kind of kicking my ass. Although we can assume, that just like all the other games in the series, that there's more than likely like a zillion phases to the boss fight. So, let's prepare ourselves for insanity. I am not doing well here. How many? He has a lot of health bars, which is fine. We can deal with it. I really gotta play this game more strategically, but honestly, it doesn't really call for it. It's like if you as long as you block here and there and then or just keep mashing X and heal, you're okay-ish. Oh no, what are you doing? This place is getting demolished. Yep, fine, we'll use flare force, I don't care. I don't know if it's even gonna hit him. Hit him a little bit. Are you gonna stop that? I want to attack you. Well, no, that's not fair. Oh, never mind. Yeah, okay, I should heal. Yeah, let's heal. Ooh. Yeah, I lost some damn train of thought, but this is just odd. But I'm liking it. Like I like how it's a actual one particular boss fight with just Master Xehanort. This is how I would have liked it for all the other people. But that would have been insane. I understand why they didn't do it. His apparel is kind of odd. It looks like kind of like a one of the four horsemen of the apocalypse type of thing going on there. Excuse me. And there they go. I don't know if these count as the various phases to the fight. Possibly. Maybe as long as we get him down to that zero, that's it. Oh, shoot. Now I gotta do... Do I really do it underwater now? Well, I guess. Interesting. The game didn't have too much underwater combat. I mean, there, here and there in the Caribbean world. But it was... You were fine, you know? It wasn't anything major. The thing is, like, look how much damage we're doing to him, you know? It's like, ow. Same time, look what he's doing to us. Can I even block properly underwater? Yeah, like, it's... I don't know. Like, I highly doubt I am overpowered. I just feel like the game could be a lot more challenging. I don't know. It's weird. And I have it on proud. I can't even imagine if you're playing on standard like I usually do, or I guess even doing beginner. But yeah, the proud didn't really punish me that much. They are releasing a patch that's going to have critical mode. So I wonder how that's going to be. Actually, they just talked about it too, where in critical mode, it's not just a matter of more HP and you have less defensive capabilities. I think it's also like, they give you new abilities where you have to play more technically or more strategically. So that's pretty cool. But yeah, this is a lot simpler than I thought it was going to be in the long run. And I'm sure a lot of people are probably complaining about it, but you know what? I'm just enjoying the ride regardless, you know? And once again, this may come from a person who was just waiting for the game for the longest time, and we're just happy we're getting to this. Oh, now we're flying! So yeah. I don't know. That's the way I look at it, anyway. Man, this man, he's mad, you know? Like, it's like, you would think, like, he would be happy because, oh, he thinks he won or something, but he's going all out. There you go. See, I can block when I feel like it. Oh, no. Oh! It's fine. I healed. Where are Donald and Goofy, by the way? How come they're not flying with me and dealing with this nonsense? Oh, that's not good. That's not good. Get out of the way. That's not far enough, Sora. What? Are you kidding me? Well, whatever. It's fine. I'll survive. Ooh, yay. Ultimate form. He's almost done. Wait a minute. Is this really all there is? Like, are there going to be various other phases? Okay, well, that little ending there makes it seem like there are other phases. I thought this was all the various phases. I guess not. I guess we're good.
It's all over, Xehanort!
You thought you could contain me here, knowing all that you do about connections? There is one sky, one destiny.
Here we freaking go. Ow, 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 ow. Okay, never mind. Is this it? I think this might be it, guys. I wish I could fight with the freaking Keyblade. I say, like, in the... Is it Latin or Greek? Or whatever. You know what I mean. Key. I mean... Holy crap, though. Look how much damage I'm doing to him. Kingdom Hearts ain't gonna help you, buddy. At least it better not help you. I don't even know where I'm hitting. Here, just taste my finisher. I love seeing that health bar dwindle down, but at the same time, maybe I shouldn't have used the ultimate keyblade. But at the same time, I worked so hard to get it, I might as well treat myself to it. But it does make me wonder, is this it? I mean, is there nothing else after this? Oh, what? What did you just do? Why am I in rage form? Oh, wow, that sucks. So now I'm just in rage form. Am I even dealing decent damage to him? Doesn't even look like it. I don't even know if I'm actually even hitting him. No, I'm not even dealing any damage to him, but I think this is what I'm meant to be. This is what I gotta do. Yes, attack him to reclaim your light. I have no choice. I wish I kind of looked up more on what the hell rage form, like, what were the pros and cons. I wanted to say I was right where it's like, you take extra damage, but I think you also deal it? Or is it only that you receive extra damage and you deal less damage? Return to the light. Wait a minute. Sonic Blade, did you guys see that? That was freaking Sonic Blade. And he's almost dead. Okay. Wait a minute. What the fudge is going on now? Oh, crap. Ow! Hold on a minute. Do I even fight these guys? Okay, never mind. I think I'm supposed to... Do I just go up there? I probably should have been just avoiding, that's it. Oh no, wait a minute, this is not going good. Oh, hold on. Last ray? Wait, is this it? You bastard!
It ends here and now.
That should be my line! I'm going to keep my eye on it, because we still have the command, option, everything going on here, so... Oh, Lord. Oh, it's gonna be a mashing contest right now, isn't it? Or I can just die. The fudge? Oh. Oh, I don't think, can you guys hear that? It's coming from my controller. Hold on. You guys might have heard that. It might have been faint, but it's them calling out to me. When I push any button on my controller, there's like a heartbeat. To call upon all your to call upon your bonds or friendship, Trinity. Whoa! Come on, Sora. The power of friendship, guys. Notice how out of all of us, it's kind of ironic how Donald has the most health out of all of us right now. Come on! Oh, it feels like an episode of Dragon Ball Z. Come on! Oh wait, was that it? I think that was it, guys. Let's find out.
Why? How?
It's over now. You lost.
No, look. You are too late.
Are we really?
I don't know.
What's gonna happen?
A purge. The world will be returned once it started. The world began in darkness, and from that darkness came light. From the light came the people, and the people had hearts. Evil burgeoned in those hearts, begetting more darkness. And the darkness spread across the world like a plague. The light, the symbol of the world's hope, was devoured by shadow, leaving nothing but ruin and utter failure. But the first light, the light of Kingdom Hearts, it can give us a new start. An empty world, pure and bright.
It wasn't your decision to make.
Then whose was it? The world needs someone to stand up and lead. Someone strong to stop the weak from polluting the world with their endless darkness. Someone to dictate their destiny.
If so, you're not that person, Xehanort. A real leader knows that destiny is beyond his control and accepts that.
You make me think of an old friend.
Look!
Oh.
Oh.
You made it!
Are you okay?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Kingdom Hearts is closing on the other side, but we managed to follow our hearts to you.
Master Xehanort. There's more to light than meets the eye. As I told you.
Hmm.
You sly fox.
What?
Now hand over the Keyblade, Xehanort.
It is too late.
For us, perhaps, but not for them.
No. I can do this.
Enough. Checkmate.
I told you that you might be surprised.
Yeah, you got me.
Huh? Really?
What?
It's just, you never admit it when you lose.
That's because I never lose.
Oh, come on.
Good game today.
I try.
Maybe I won't go as far as you.
Huh?
When the world needs a defender, they'll pick you, Ericus.
Huh? You think?
But that doesn't mean that I can't be there for you.
Yeah, and I'll be there for you.
Very well done. Terra, Aqua, then. Forgive your foolish teacher.
Master!
Master!
Master.
I put you through such a harrowing experience. And Aqua, I left you with such a heavy burden. Terra, look after them for me. Please. Here. Ready, my friend?
Yes.
Sora, let's close it.
Everybody help me out.
That Master Erica scene really was a lot more touching than I thought it was going to be.
It's finally over.
No.
We'll find Kairi. Let's head back to Master Yen Sid. We can figure it out.
No. I know what to do.
Sora!
My whole journey began the day I lost her. And every time I find her, she slips away again. I thought we'd finally be together, but she's out there, alone. Not for one more second.
Welcome too!
That's right!
Thank you, Donald, Goofy. But this time, I have to go it alone.
Sora, listen. The power of waking isn't to go chase hearts around. Even if you do locate Kairi, you might never come home to us again.
I will. And we'll both be back before you know it.
Please!
Let him go, Mickey.
Riku!
His heart and his mind are made up. Now believe in him.
Yeah. Safe journey, Sora.
Thank you.
Thank you.
in a kingdom of thieves and people who say things they don't really mean, really mean. Oh, you're only everything I ever dreamed, ever dreamed of, ever dreamed of. You must be kidding me, did you really think I could say no? I want you for a lifetime, so if you're gonna think twice, baby, I don't wanna know, baby, I don't wanna know. Everything is just right, but if you're gonna think twice, baby, I don't wanna know, baby, I don't wanna know. I really don't give.
What even just happened? Like, first off, holy crap, that whole ending sequence. Oh man, that was everything I kind of wanted in terms of a conclusion for a lot of people's stories. It's nice to see Aiza back, and he's friends with Lee, and it's cool to see that they actually have his other clothes on. Shion's there. The gang from Traverse Town. Naminé? But what the fudge was that ending right there? Like, did he find Kairi? Is he still out there? The little thing is like, how come he only faded away? What were they actually there or not? Because I was getting ready. I'm like, okay, here comes Kingdom Hearts 4. Where we're gonna have to find Kairi, then that happened, and it's like, what? Oh my god, that's gonna take me some time to kind of process everything together to see just what happened there, but oh my god, what a, I'm happy as all hell, and honestly, this song that's playing, I probably shouldn't keep it in the video because, obviously, the music is not gonna go through if I demonetize it, but honestly, I'll let it go this time. I think one of my other videos is already demonetized for like one segment of song, so you know what, F it. I just kinda wanna share this little experience. Dear God, you know, It's finally here, like I beat the game. Like, this is what I was always worried about, is like, I'm gonna beat the game and conclude the story, and in a sense I did, but that ending kind of left it open where it's like, alright. And that scene right there, for God's sakes, just kind of ruined me. Oh, we need a Kingdom Hearts 4 now. Let's wait another 15 years or whatever. Was it 13, 14, whatever. But we got Jason Pooh Bear Boyd. Okay. I like the ending theme. I really did not enjoy the opening theme as much. This ending theme was amazing though. I like it. I just realized something. Okay, yeah, this. Okay, well, now they're on different sides. Okay, well, that whole thing, and there's a secret movie that's still coming up. Is it coming up right now? Oh, well, I guess not. Maybe after all this. Yeah, they did change the voice actress for Kairi. It used to be Hayden Panettiere, but they have Alison Stoner playing her now. Quentin Flynn, honestly, is a... I just think of him as Raiden in the Metal Gear Solid series. Drake Bell? Really? Was the young Ericus? I did not know that. Okay. I love how they don't have the voice actors for the movies. They just have like, oh, well, here are the characters. It's like, well, that's great and all. How about you actually tell us who played those guys and women? But so be it. Oh, wow. Well, they're all lumped in there, so... that's cool. That's cool. So yeah, Zach Levy. He did reprise his role for Flynn. Wow. That was something, guys. That was... Oh, man. Really? Matthew Mercer played Ira? Huh. Oh, that was Mark Hamill. Oh! Playing Master Ericus. Okay, well, there's the little post-credit thing a little bit. They're just rebuilding. Oh, that's nice. Oh, man. Yeah, so, sorry, I know I keep losing my train of thought, but what a journey that was. Of course, I'm sad that, you know, it's finally over. At least this game. It looks like the series is far from being over, which they've confirmed numerous times that this game ends the Dark Seeker saga, which is basically around Master Eric, well, Master Xehanort, and, you know, trying to form the Keyblade, the open Kingdom Hearts, and control it. So, now it's all taken care of. It does make you wonder, what is the other looming threat? There has to be something, you know? You know, now that I think about it, it's like, now that Disney owns a bunch of other licenses, you know, including Star Wars and Marvel. That Marvel one is a huge one. Because why do I just imagine it's going to delve into another, like, huge, like, Avengers game? Or like, an Avengers thing. Like, we got to protect everybody from freaking Thanos. And that, cool, that thing there, Verum Rex, was... interesting, to say the least. Is Andy coming home? They're not gonna show it, obviously. We can only assume... they didn't show it. Well, we figured. So I guess I should delve into my, final thoughts and opinions of this game. So, I mean, I think you guys know. You know, like, I very thoroughly enjoyed myself. And I'm happy with the end result. Could there have been a lot of things better? Or, like, you know, done better in the game? Oh, hell yes, of course, you know. I firmly believe there's no such thing as a perfect game. There isn't. And for here, I keep going back to the story. Part of me, and I know this may not make sense, but part of me feels like it kind of was fast in a sense, you know? But I guess what we have to forget, what I tend to forget, is the story obviously builds upon so many other games. And it's like you need to have that lore kind of down to understand everything that went here, you know? But I don't know why I just have that feeling that it went by kind of quick, but this is a conclusion to the story, so it's like everything is going to be winding down here, and that's exactly what happened. Maybe because a lot happened. Maybe because it's like freaking Ven, Terra, and Aqua were all saved, and they're back together. We finally were able to get Roxas out from Sora's heart, and Shion is back, and Lee / Axel, they're back. I mean, I wasn't gonna say, you know, Sora, Riku, and Kairi, but then that thing happened at the end. So, it's just... A lot happened, yes. But it was so, to me, also fulfilling, if that makes sense. And I enjoyed the combat. I really enjoyed the combat. I do wish that they gave you an option. Well, there goes my controller. But I do wish they gave you an option to... how do I say this? Oh, sorry, I lost my train of thought. Oh, you have an option to disable the situation command. So what I mean by that is mainly either like have a choice to disable the attractions, disable the team attacks, or disable the transformations, one thing or another, you know? Have choices for that depending on how the person wants to play, because personally, I would have turned off the attractions earlier if I could do so. I say this, it makes it seem like I hate the attractions. That's absolutely not right. I really enjoy the attractions. It's just, in terms of combat, the way I like to play is I'd rather just kind of just do my thing, you know, don't have to worry about using the attractions to defeat whoever. But, you know, they're there. They're cool. They're fun to use. But if they gave me an option to just remove it while I'm playing, that would have been even better. Even the difficulty of the game. I was honestly expecting a lot more, especially playing on Proud. So it makes me wonder if I play this on normal or beginner or standard, whatever, I would have probably felt a little unaccomplished. Because in the other games, when I'm playing on standard, I still got my butt kicked here and there. And I don't know if that's because of the limitations of the gameplay mechanics back then, or what. But here, I mean, of course there are times I got close to dying, don't get me wrong. But as soon as I healed, boom, you know, I was kind of back in the game. Didn't have much to worry about. Well, I think I died like, what? 2-3 times? And then besides the gunship battle, the gunship section, just because I just didn't build my ship right, but that one secret boss, or the Einheit or whatever. I think it comes from the game Einheit. But regardless, that kicked my butt. But yeah, it was just weird. I was expecting to be a lot more in terms of difficulty, and especially towards the ending. Yeah, there were a lot of boss fights per se, but it wasn't memorable in my eyes to the extent of like the individual fights. I mean, obviously they weren't kind of there, they were all obviously grouped together. But I think because they're grouped together, it was kind of like, eh, whatever, you know? But it's understandable why. It's like, yeah, you're going to have the showdown with the 13 vessels of darkness. Do you really think that they want to put in 13 separate boss fights? It would have been insane. So I understand why it was done. I feel like it kind of took away the impact a little bit, for me anyway. And even for the final boss fight, it was pretty cool. Although still kind of lackluster in a sense compared to the other two, especially the one of Xemnas, because that was like all over the place. And even the one of Ansem, like he transformed into something odd at the end of the original Kingdom Hearts. Here it's like he kind of had different forms, but I don't know. It was just kind of eh compared to those two. But still a pretty awesome final boss fight, especially at the end there, where it's like you do have to wake up Sora, call back to him, and then that was it. And of course, a lot of people will also say like the story is definitely hit or miss, especially in terms of writing. I will admit, I said this so many times during the LP, but the writing can be pretty cringy, and like if you want to say predictable, it's like, a lot of times it's like, just use the word friendship, hearts, strength, darkness, hope, light, and you have the story for Kingdom Hearts, you know? Like, I understand why it's like that, but it's like, oh man, I wonder if they could have written it any better. but I kind of take it for what it is. Once again, it is biased, I guess, because, you know, I am a fan of the series, so I say whatever. But it does make me wonder. I should see how people who never played a Kingdom Hearts game before and they dove right into this, what their thoughts are. It doesn't make... I mean, personally, I would say it doesn't make sense to dive right into this if you haven't played the others, but with this being on the Xbox, I'm sure there were so many people that this was their first dive into the series. So they must have been lost, and you know what? That's... I mentioned this before, too. It's where, you know, there's no wrong way to play the game. Any game. If you enjoy yourself, boom, that's it. You enjoy yourself, that's the game's job. And you did it, and this game definitely did that for me. So, I mean, overall, I loved this game. It's not perfect, but, you know, for the wait I endured and what I experienced, I thoroughly enjoyed the ride. And that, ladies and gentlemen, was Kingdom Hearts 3. Now, do we get the secret movie?
Finally, back where it belongs.
Did you summon us back?
Yep.
Is that you, Lucio? You look different.
Haven't heard that name in a long while. These days they call me Zigbar, but hey, whatever suits you.
Is it really you?
Yeah, but some time ago I had to cast my old form away. Been through plenty more semblances since, but it's still me underneath it all.
What happened? Why are we here? You tell me!
I had a role to play. And after all these years, it's done.
What role?
I guess Ava didn't make it after all.
Meaning what?
I told her, clear as day, what it is I had to do.
And is that why you decided to exclude her?
As if. Ava had her own mission, and she carried it out.
I've heard enough! Lushu, what was your role?
I hope you like long stories.
What's this?
I heard about this new game.
Seven black pieces, and?
Just watch.
Does somebody want to tell me what in the name of fudge I just saw right there? I think that last portion of Sora, Riku, and that guy from freaking Verum Rex, Yozora, that was a secret ending. I think everything before that, that was just the ending of the game. And holy crap, I saw only a little bit of that movie, the Union Cross, whatever it was called. I keep forgetting the name of it. I saw a bit of it, so I know some of those characters that appear at the end. Holy crap! Lushu? That Lushu? Freaking Zigbar saying went through various iterations? What the fudge was that? Totally forgot that Maleficent and Pete were even in this damn game. I still don't know what the hell's in that black box. Oh. The whole thing of that secret ending, though, right there, whatever the hell I just saw. Why the fudge was it Sora and Riku? Why the fudge were they in Shibuya? That was the 10-4 building from The World Ends With You. And then what the fudge is up with Verum Rex or Yozora and whoever else was... I think the whole purpose was they look at the moon, the heart. It's like, are they trying to make a new Kingdom Hearts? You know, I don't know. I don't know. That kind of just kind of threw things out of the window for me. That was... Whoo! Where's Kingdom Hearts 4? I can't do this now. Now I can't wait anymore. Damn it, I gotta do this all over again. I gotta wait all over again. Joy. Anyway, here is my battle report. And Yeah, favorite deputy, I guess, was my favorite one to use. Definitely. That's quite a lot of distance traveled. Flare Force, yeah, it did seem like came up a lot more than Goofy's attack, the Bombardier one. That bothers me that my gunship completion is at 97. I think it's because there's that one item I missed. I think I had to defeat that other hard boss on with an A rank. I think that's the only reason why I'm sitting at 97%. That bothers me a little bit. Oh my god, I totally forgot to use a cuisine. That's why I wanted to do that before we got into the final fight, but it kind of just happened. So, whoops. Maybe I'll do that when I do the super boss in the game. Totally did not use that cuisine mechanic whatsoever. And everything, somehow, was 81 hours. That could have been a lot shorter, but... Anyway, on the next screen, you can save game clear data. This save data will be marked with a crown and let you continue the adventure just before the final battle. Okay. Then, so be it. Wow. That was a hell of a journey. And that ending. Boy, last lost masters, yeah. Yzora. That's the secret ending right there, Yzora. That, I still can't believe. That's... Wow. I mean, that was Shibuya, right? That was the 10-4 building. Although, I'm not sure, I think Sora and Riku in the same area. I just didn't know what Riku was staring at. But the whole thing about Verum Rex, that so confuses me. But this whole epilogue was insane too. I need to finish watching that movie. I mean, I was glad I was able to understand a little bit what happened here. But I need to watch the movie. Wow. And then it's like, you guys can read this to figure out, you know, the rest of the story. Whew. Yeah, guys, that was something. Now, of course, I think I'm excited because I have been a fan of the series for a long time, and I want more. Who doesn't? At least, you know, everybody wants more of something, you know? As long as you don't tarnish it. But it does make me wonder how people who've never played the series before, what they felt when they got to that, you know? Like, that's why I'm so adamant that they really should play the other games in the series to get the full effect of what this game was meant to do, you know? Either way, I've already went to my final thoughts. I thoroughly enjoyed this game. I loved every second of it. It wasn't perfect. Of course there were a lot of flaws with it, but I enjoyed it for what it was. I guess we can begin the countdown for Kingdom Hearts 4, or whatever they're planning on calling it. It can be something else until we get the next mainline series. I just realized, when the next game probably comes out, I'm going to be 30-something. That's something. Considering that I was like, what, 13, 14? When the first game in the series came out. Yeah, that makes me think a little. Ladies and gentlemen, I can't thank you all enough for being patient with me playing this game and tuning in. There's so many people playing this game who have played a game, who've done a lot better than I did, or didn't ramble on, didn't do this, didn't do that. But for those who decided to watch my series, I can't thank you enough. Until the next Kingdom Hearts games, guys, I'll be... Now I'm free to kind of dive into other projects. Well, hold on. We're not exactly done with this. The only thing I'd like to do now is the post-game content, which is the Battle Gates. And apparently the Battle Gates are tied in with that one menu, or that one feature in the menu that was locked. Apparently it has to deal with that, and sorry about that. So I'm going to do that as a bonus video. I hope it's probably going to be one big video. At least I think so. And I don't think there's really anything else I'd like to do on screen. I'm sure I can upgrade all the Keyblades for a hell of it. I can synthesize everything, get all the trophies, but I never was aiming for that per se. So yeah, next time I'll show off the Battle Gates and hopefully do well in the Super Boss. But I think besides that, that's it for my journey for Kingdom Hearts 3, and I hope you all enjoyed it. So, as usual, thank you all so much for watching my Let's Play of Kingdom Hearts 3. I love you all so damn much. Have a great day.
Thank you all for watching this video. If you enjoyed what you saw, feel free to leave a comment, a like, and subscribe for future content, where I aim to release a video a day. And if you do subscribe, make sure to click on the bell symbol to be notified once new videos are uploaded. You can also catch me streaming from time to time on Twitch, follow me on Twitter, and join my Discord server to relax with other gamers. All this information is in the description box below. Have a great day.